This Mass is offered for the following intentions. Blessing and good health of Sister Antoinette Aranjo and the Sisters of Premankur, for the souls of Albert Raymond Franklin Sequeira Munsmine, Abigail D'Souza, Julie D'Souza, Leo Kinney, Franklin Miranda, Apollina Menezes, Jude Correa, Neville Suarez, and deceased members of Pinto Lobo and Suarez families, Matthew and Jane Bundu, Mari D'Souza, Edwin D'Souza, Raymond and Molly Remedios, Joseph and Philomena Rani, Francis D'Souza, Dennis and Michael Scombs, John and Olga Barreto, Frank and Lisa Ferreira, and the deceased members of the family. We also pray for all your intentions, those who celebrate their birthdays and anniversaries today. Together. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the priceless communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, the essence of a true religion is the right relationship with God and others. To be religious is not enough. What is needed is to be righteous. Let us pray at this Eucharist that we are righteous in our thoughts, words, and deeds. To celebrate the sacred mysteries of this Eucharist in a worthy manner, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord's pardon and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Keep your family safe, O Lord, with unfailing care, that relying solely on the hope of heavenly grace, they may be defended always by your protection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. God said, let the waters swarm with swarms of living creatures, and let birds fly above the earth, across the firmament of the heavens. So God created the great sea creatures, and every living creature that moves, with which the waters swarm according to their kinds, and every winged bird according to its kind. And God saw that it was good. And God blessed them, saying, be fruitful and multiply, and fill the waters in the sea, and let birds multiply on the earth. And there was evening, and there was morning, the fifth day. And God said, let the earth bring forth living creatures according to their kinds, livestock and creeping things, and beasts of the earth according to their kinds. And it was so. And God made the beasts of the earth according to their kinds, and the livestock according to their kinds, and everything that creeps on the ground according to its kind. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish. of the sea, and over the birds of the heavens, and over the livestock, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps on the earth. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them. And God blessed them, and God said to them, be fruitful and multiply, and fill the earth and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the heavens, and over every living thing that moves on the earth. And God said, behold, I have given you every plant yielding seed that is on the face of all the earth, and every tree with seeds in its fruit. You shall have them for food. And to every beast of the earth, and to every bird of the heavens, and to everything that creeps on the earth, everything that has the breath of life, I have given every green plant for food. And it was so. And God saw everything that he had made, and behold, it was good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth were finished, and all the host of them. And on the seventh day, God finished his work that he had done. And he rested on the seventh day from all his work that he had done. So God blessed the seventh day and made it holy, because on it God rested from all his work that he had done in creation. These are the generations of the heavens and the earth that were created. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The words of your response are, O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name through all the earth. Kindly listen to the tune.
O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name through all the earth. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name through all the earth.
When I see the heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you arrange, what is man that you should keep him in mind? The son of man that you care for him altogether.
O Lord our God, how majestic is your name through all the earth.
Yet you have made him little lower than the angels. With glory and honor you crowned him, gave him power over the works of your hands.
O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name through all the earth. Alleluia, Alleluia.
Bend my heart, O God, to your decree. Grant me mercy by your law.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
At that time, when the Pharisees gathered to Jesus with some of the scribes who had come from Jerusalem, they saw that some of his disciples ate with hands that were defiled, that is, unwashed. For the Pharisees and all the Jews, they do not eat unless they wash their hands properly, holding to the tradition of the elders, and when they come from the marketplace, they do not eat unless they wash. And there are many other traditions that they observe, such as the washing of cups and pots and copper vessels and dining couches. And the Pharisees and the scribes asked him, why do your disciples not walk according to the tradition of the elders, but eat with defiled hands? And he said to them, Well, did Isaiah prophesy of you hypocrites, as it is written, This people honors me with their lips, but their heart is far from me. In vain do they worship me, teaching as doctrines the commandments of men. You leave the commandment of God and hold to the tradition of men. And he said to them, You have a fine way of rejecting the commandment of God in order to establish your tradition. For Moses said, Honor your father and your mother, and whoever reviles father or mother must surely die. But you say, If a man tells his father or his mother, Whatever you would have gained from me is korban, that is, given to God, then you no longer permit him to do anything for his father or mother, thus making void the word of God by your tradition that you have handed down, and many such things you do. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The Gospel passage, my dear friends, describes Jesus' confrontation with scribes and Pharisees sent from Jerusalem by the Jewish religion Supreme Court, the Sanhedrin, to assess Jesus' heretical teachings. They question Jesus as to why he doesn't command his disciples to observe the ritual purification of hands before meals or at a banquet. Ritual purification, my dear friends, is some kind of a moral purity which the Jews believe that they must have before approaching to God. Jesus, my dear friends, criticizes questioners. Jesus shocks them by accusing them of hypocrisy and rendering mere lip service, and very specially changing God's laws and giving them man-made interpretations. Jesus teaches us, true defilement takes place only in the heart and in mind. The essence of a religion is to have a right relationship with God and others. To be religious is good, but at the same time, what is best is to be righteous before God and others. Amen.
Sacrament of eternal life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For just as through your beloved Son, you created the human race, so also through him, with great goodness, you formed it anew. And so it is right that all your creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, and all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore, we too extol you with all the angels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy.
By sending down your spirit upon them like the new fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it and gave it to his disciples saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Oswald Gracious, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. and within and in him. O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours. Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
We now make an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus,
I believe
that you are present
in the most holy sacrament.
I love you
above all things,
and I desire
to receive you
into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment
receive you sacramentally,
come at least spiritually
into my heart.
I embrace you
as if you were already there
and unite myself
wholly to you.
Never permit me
to be separated from you.
Amen.
My God.
sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion, Abba Father, save us from the virus and bless our country. For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion,
Abba Father, save us from the virus and bless our country.
For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion, Abba Father, save us from the virus and bless our country. For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion, Abba Father, save us from the virus and bless our country. For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion,
Abba Father, save us from the virus and bless our country.
O God, who have willed that we be partakers in the one bread and the one chalice, grant us, we pray, so to live that made one in Christ, we may joyfully bear fruit for the salvation of the world through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Our Lady of Mount Carmel,
pray for us.
My heart's like a flute, and I want to play all day. Jesus Christ is my music master. Deep from my heart flows a simple melody.